Happy morning, all of you. My name is Mr. Khadangale Pankaj. Today I am here with the subject EVS Second. Our chapter's name is Shivaji's Childhood. In this chapter, yesterday we have learned about Shahaji Raje towards the Mughals. So see, who is Shahaji Raje? I told you, Shivaji Maharaj's father's name is Shahaji Raje. Okay. Now, see, what we have seen in last chapter, Shahaji Raje was in Nizam Shahi. Where he was? Nizam Shahi. Shahaji Raje was in Nizam Shahi. But Fateh Khan was feeling jealous from Shahaji Raje. So, Shahaji Raje left this Nizam Shahi. What did he do? He left it. He left the Nizam Shahi because of Fateh Khan. And then he joined Adil Shah of Bijapur. What did he join? Adil Shah of Bijapur. Okay? He left it and here join Adil Shah of Bijapur. But Fateh Khan was unable to handle Nizam Shahi properly. So Nizam Shahi was going down. So Nizam Shah's mother requested to Shahaji Raje to join again Nizam Shahi. Who requested? Nizam Shah's mother requested to Shahaji Raje. So see, from here he went in Adil Shahi. But due to his mother's request, Shahaji Raje left Adil Shahi again. He left it again. And then again he returned to Nizam Shahi. Again he returned to Nizam Shahi. But this Nizam Shah, he was a fickle-minded person. He used to trust on people's gossiping, and because of that gossiping he killed Lakhuji Rao Jadhav in the court. So Shahaji Raje again left this Nizam Shahi again. Now second time again he left it, and now whom he joined? He joined to Mughals. He joined Mughals. Okay, I'll write here. Mughals. He joined Mughals again. Okay, but here now again what happened? This Fateh Khan, what this Fateh Khan did? Fateh Khan joined his hands with Mughals and he killed Nizam Shah only. Who? Fateh Khan. Fateh Khan killed Nizam Shah, his king. He killed him. And now what he has decided? He has decided to give this Nizam Shahi to Mughals. So as per this, he gave Nizam Shahi to Mughals, and in return these Mughals gave Fateh Khan territories which were under the Shahaji Raje. All those territories were given to Fateh Khan. So now Shahaji Raje again he left this Mughals also. So now he is not in Nizam Shahi also, not in Adil Shahi also, and not in Mughals also. So he don't have now any options, and he was not thinking about any options. So now what he decided? He decided that he will establish something new and then he will fight against these people. Okay, so that point we are going to learn. Do you understand this much? This is very important. Whatever we have learned yesterday, that we have revised here in short. Okay, now today we will learn new point. So till the time, open your textbook, page number 14. See, only few students are completing homework. Only 8-10 students are completing homework. So you have to complete your homework regularly. Okay? Now see, which point is there today? Founding of a new Nizamshahi. Founding of new Nizamshahi. Founding of new Nizamshahi. Open your book, see. First of all, I'll read it and then I'll explain you. Okay. Till the time, this index finger you have to put on the line. Here also some difficult words are there. Okay. So see, founding of a new Nizamshahi. In order to forestall the Mughal Emperor and Wazir Fateh Khan, Shahaji Raje found out a child here from the Nizam Shah's family. And on the fort of Pemgiri near Junnar declared him as the new Nizam Shah. Thus, he established an altogether new kingdom which included the territory between the rivers Godavari and Nira. Shahaji Raje fought vigorously to protect his new state. Initially, Adil Shah was with him in these efforts, but later, the Mughal Emperor Shahjahan himself marched south upon Shahaji Raje and threatened Adil Shah. Adil Shah then signed a treaty of friendship with him against Shahaji Raje. Shahaji Raje now began to fight the joint force of the Mughals and Adil Shah using guerrilla tactics. But he could not sustain the war all by himself. In 1636, unwillingly, he signed a treaty of peace with Mughals. He could not create his own kingdom as the times were not favorable for him. But his daring spirit kindled a confidence among the Marathi people. This proved useful for Shivaji in establishing Swaraj a few years later. Okay, so this much we are going to see today. So see, founding of Nizamshahi, new Nizamshahi. See, I'll explain you here again. I rough it. This one, Nizamshahi, N for Nizamshahi, Adilshahi, and then Mughals. So like this, Shahaji Raje left all these peoples. Okay. So, what is told? See, in order to forestall the Mughal Emperor and Wazir Fateh Khan, Shahaji Raje found out a child here from Nizam Shah's family. See, now what Shahaji Raje did? Shahaji Raje formed here new Nizam Shahi. What he formed? New Nizam Shahi. New Nizamshahi. Okay. So Shahaji Raje was in Nizamshahi. He left it. He joined Adilshahi. Due to Nizam Shah's mother's request, he left Adilshahi. Again, he joined Nizamshahi. Again, due to some circumstances, he left Nizamshahi and he joined Mughals. Again, Mughals joined with Fateh Khan. So Shahaji Raja left Mughals also. Now he established new Nizam Shahi. How he established? He found a hare. Hare means H-E-I-R, hare. Hare means a person legally entitled the property. A person legally entitled to the property. Okay? Means one's properties, means your father's property. In future it will be your. Okay? So you are legally entitled to the property. Okay? Legally you will get that property. Understood? So like this. So Shahaji Raja found a boy. Here means a person who is legally entitled to the property. So he found one Nizam Shah's son. Nizam Shah's relative or his heir. He found it. And he, see, a child here from the Nizam Shah's family, and declared him as the new Nizam Shah, and declared him as new Nizam Shah, because this one, old Nizam Shah, was killed by Fateh Khan, his wazir. Nizam Shah's wazir was Fateh Khan, and his wazir only he killed to Nizam Shah. So now there is no Nizam Shah. So he formed now, and what he did, he gave this Nizam Shahi to Mughals. So it became one now. Okay, Nizam Shah is in under the control of Mughals. Okay, now, so he declared this new heir, that new Nizam Shah, where on the fort of Pemgiri near Junnar. Fort's name is Pemgiri. Okay, Pemgiri, it is near the Junnar. Declared him as new Nizam Shah. Thus, he established an altogether new kingdom, which included the territory between the rivers Godavari and Ira. And he established his new kingdom in where it was in between Godavari and Nira. It was in between Godavari and Nira. Shahaji Raja fought vigorously to protect his new state. And this Shahaji Raja fought. Now he is fighting with these people, Mughals and Shahaji Raja. Okay. Now this Nizam Shahi is under the control of Mughals, old Nizam Shahi. So we'll consider it as a Mughal only. So all Mughals are, he was fighting with Mughals vigorously to protect his new state. Initially, Adil Shah was with him in these efforts. So he was fighting with Mughals. So this Adil Shah, he also came with new Nizam Shahi, means with Shahaji Raja. So Adil Shah and Shahaji Raja, they were fighting with Mughals. But what happened? See, the Mughal Emperor Shahjahan, your emperor was Shahjahan. So Shahjahan himself marched south upon Shahaji Raja and threatened Adil Shah. So here he marched on Shahaji Raja, and he bring in difficulty. He bring Adil Shah in difficulty. Who? Shahjahan. Shahjahan bring Adil Shah in difficulty. So this Adil Shah, who was helping to Shahaji Raja, he left his work. He stopped his work. He stopped his work. And Adil Shah then signed a treaty of friendship. Treaty means agreement. He agreed a friendship with Shahjahan against Shahaji Raja. So now this Adil Shah become friend of Mughals. He became friend of Mughals. He was helping to Shahaji Raja, but this Mughal brought them in difficulty. So to release that difficulty, he joined friendship with Mughals and stopped helping to Shahaji Raja. Now again Shahaji Raja became alone. still he was fighting with these people. Shahaji Raja now began to fight the joint force of Mughals and Adil Shah using guerrilla tactics. Means now Shahaji Raja, he was fighting with Adil Shah also and Mughals also. First he was fighting with Mughals only, but now Adil Shah is also in his opposition. So he was fighting with, he started to fight with Adil Shah also. But he was using guerrilla tactics. Means with techniques he was fighting with these people. But he could not sustain. Sustain means maintain. He could not sustain the war all by himself. He could not continue that war for more time. In 1636, unwillingly, he signed a treaty of peace with Mughals. So in 1636, he made agreement with Mughals. He could not create his own kingdom, and Shahaji Raja could not create his own kingdom as the times were not favorable for him, because time was not favorable for him. But his daring spirit kindled a confidence among the Marathi people. But his daring brought a confidence in Marathi people. And this proved useful for Shivaji in establishing Swaraj a few years later. And this only helped Shivaji Maharaj to establish new Swaraj in Maharashtra. Okay? So like this, founding of new Nizam Shahi. Do you understand? If you are not understand, again and again you will see this diagram. Okay? You have to try to explain this. So automatically you will learn it. So what is today's your homework? From this paragraph you will find out some hard words. So same homework you will get on the screen at the last. So thanks for watching this video. Tomorrow again we will meet with the new point named as Jizabai and Shivaji in Karnataka. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Thank you very much.